unless wait. Unless Denver was going to fucking take him. And the Falcons going to pick up Jerry Jeudy and CeeDee Lamb and trade his ass back over.
Nope. Denver going to take a receiver. Denver going to take one of the receivers.
Well, now, because you needed somebody next to Von Miller to show up that goddamn defense. Maybe the Falcons thought that, hey, shit.
Yeah, Denver might go ahead and sign Cam Newton to pick up a wideout.
Okay, but
just picked up Melvin Gordon. Like, they might beef that offense up real quick.
Traded to the Atlanta Falcons after this goddamn pick.
Now, why trade now? They're going to follow you out.
No, because you didn't know that. You didn't know what Denver was going to do from a Falcon perspective.
Damn. I was liking that pick, that Javon.
I was thinking that they were going to take an offensive lineman off the rip, and I was like, shit, the Falcons may get fucking Ken Law.
Yeah, that damn defense.
Apparently not.
Damn. Nah.
They comparing to Richard Seymour? Wow. Damn. That's high praise.
Shit.
I like that kid. I got this a couple of times this year. I like him. He's a baller. Got a couple of injury questions, but he's a baller.
Yeah. Shit, man.
That'd have been a good one for the Falcons, wouldn't it?
It's been they picked. That's the one they wanted.
Yeah, I know.
Well, the Falcons still gonna take AJ Terrell, baby. AJ Terrell.
Out of Westlake.
You still got Espinosa and Chaisson.
Yep.
Well, Chaisson, a linebacker, but
I can see taking AJ Terrell, hometown kid out of Westlake, coming there. You know, feels the cornerback need because he's the first. You know,
come back on.
Okay, all right, we kicked off. Put me off. So yeah,
but I got another question for you.
Mm-hmm.
Who's gonna be the best SEC quarterback to come out of the draft this year?
Clearly Burrows.
Oh shit.
You said clearly Burrow. He went to Cincinnati. It's not clearly Burrow at all.
I still think he's gonna be a good quarterback.
Look at their situations. Like you gotta put a little bit more thought into this. Yeah. You got Burrow to Cincinnati. Tua, did he go to the Dolphins or the Chargers? He went to the Dolphins. You got Tua to the Dolphins, and you don't know, Jalen is kind of like a hybrid SEC pick.
Yeah, I was going to ask you, are you looking at played in the SEC and finished up somewhere else? Because if you're looking at it right now, you got Tua and you got Burrow. So, who are we?
We're looking at the teams they went to, you would probably think Tua would do better over in Miami. But he may not come out the gate starting right now.
But Miami has a tougher schedule.
But that's why I say he may not start. He may not come out the gate starting. You know what I mean? They may bring him along pretty slow.
But then, you got your boy, y'all boy. You don't think Fromm will come out and start somewhere?
No.
Nah, I don't.
Fuck Fromm.
No, sir.
But y'all think the rest of the offense is top flight. But we all agree he's trash.
What happened to Mace?
We lost Mason. I think we lost the feed,
I'm trying to get him back.
Feed's still there.
Feed's still here.
I said the feed.
Yeah, we did. We went off at 10,
so I just started another one. We back now, though.
Oh, my God. Look at that. Boy,
so I need to end my watch party and start a new one.
So that one ended. Yep, I got to go back in and find it.
Well, thanks for telling me.
Appreciate you telling me.
It just happened. It ain't even 30 seconds.
Well, you knew it was going to happen. Hey, man, you use on top of your shit. You sitting at the Mike Bell, shit fucked up over there.
Yeah, he is.
Hey, man, these folk got my fun. Everybody's so mad. They got everything crashing over here. iPad crashing.
They got it crashing,
bro. Everybody like, the Falcons going to take a receiver. The Falcons would be crazy to take a receiver.
Oh, man, they'll fire everybody.
That'll be so stupid.
I'll tell you, dude, we going to log off. I'm just going to hit the button. We ain't going to discuss it.
That would be insane to take a receiver. Like, everything the Falcons need to pick is defense. Like, dude,
how many more weapons?
The whole draft need to be defensive. If you do offense, it's offensive line.
Boy, Mike Wilson in the house, Rollin John in this thing. Like they logging into the new watch party.
Charlotte B, what did it do, baby?
It's starting back up. We back on.
See what these Broncos do.
Hey, Okie D.
Falcons is going. They're going to destroy this pick.
Hey, we got
Marty Marr back in his thing.
Okie D home checking in. Oh, what it do? DFW finding.
John Elway smiling. John Elway gonna get somebody to go opposite Courtland Sutton.
They over there with Jerry Jeudy. That's who they looking at in the room.
Got to get somebody to go for Drew Lock. Drew Lock need another weapon.
Drew Lock ain't gonna be the quarterback. I'm telling you, Denver is about to pick up Cam.
Falcons on the clock. Did we miss that
there
pick?
We go. Jerry Jeudy to Denver.
Okay.
They getting ready to bring in their quarterback.
Jerry Jeudy, we told you.
Jerry Jeudy to Denver.
They getting ready to bring in their quarterback. They bringing in weapons.
Oh.
They got Melvin Gordon. Now they got Jerry Jeudy.
Man, I'm starting to sweat. That's sweet. My boy's on the clock, and I'm starting to sweat, man. That ain't good.
It's starting to get right.
Let's go, Falcons on the clock. Let's go.
This thing about to get real.
Goddamn, with Simone TD. Logged in.
What up? Hey.
Falcons on the clock.
Ronnie logged in. We got Buffalo in the house.
Wow.
What the fuck, man? Hey, will they fuck it up this time? What they going to do? What they going to do? What they going to do?
The Falcons are on the clock. Let's see how they blow it today.
What you think, Scott Hill? I see you out there, man. Who you think the Falcons need to draft, man? Get at us.
They're going to do something stupid.
Uh-oh, they clapping over here. Who is that?
He ain't got no Falcon head on, dude.
Oh, it doesn't matter. The Falcons about to do something real stupid. No,
that's Denver. That's Denver. Okay, that's Jerry Jeudy.
They're going to draft somebody they do not need. DeMond in the house. Head Q. There you go.
I'm expecting Chase Son or either this linebacker, man.
No, the Falcons going to do something just extremely stupid.
I mean, Espinosa.
But it looks just like everybody else. The Falcons are going to take their whole time.
Espinosa or this linebacker, Chase Son. I keep saying it, bro. That's
the kid from LSU.
AJ
Terrell.
While we wait on these raggedy, faulty birds to make a pick.
Hey, man.
Should the running backs.
Watch your mouth. Chill that shit,
bro. Should the running backs be valued more?
No.
Well, they've already proven that they don't have to do that. They can get production behind, you know, first-year guys. I don't know what you think about value more when they're like.
We know McCaffrey got his money.
Yeah, we know why McCaffrey got his money.
He's been balling. Derrick Henry got franchised, and we already know what happened with Todd Gurley and Le'Veon Bell. They've been getting money. But they're screwing up the market for each other.
That's why their value is not going anywhere. I can get that same production out of a Saquon Barkley or somebody coming out of college that I can get out of these cats.
What's up, Oakley Holmes? Leon Brooks.
Appreciate that, Simone.
Talmadge Thomas. Everybody checking in right about now.
Man named Talmadge.
I said Talmadge Thomas.
No. See. Talmadge.
Oh, you want to put emphasis on Talmadge. Right.
Motherfucker named Talmadge. You know they from South Georgia. Talmadge.
Like, man, they devalue in the running back position so much.
Ooh.
So,
Judy. The Judy highlights just sick.
Your local Tampa fans say y'all boys going to pick another injury prone player.
We lost your visual, Maceo.
Uh-oh, because my phone keep ringing.
They keep calling. They blowing him up. They keep calling me to come back to these streets. They calling
somebody who's going
to
get hurt.
To come back to these streets. Hey, man, Fee, we're going to mute your fucking mic.
You can't mute me. You ain't in the studio either.
You're officially a fucking hater. You are officially a fucking hater.
All I did was read the comments from the chat room. That's it.
It sounds like it's coming from your ass, though. It's the same fucking sentiment.
Okay, I see you, Scott. Scott said LSU Chase Son as well. All right, I'm with you, Chop. Me and you on the same page, bro.
This is typically the what the fuck moment that the Falcon fans have.
I'm over here sweating, Scott. I'm sweating, man.
The Falcons are going to pick
my deodorant wearing off right about now, man.
Mike, what are they doing?
Mike, why are you sweating over there?
I mean, golly, man.
The pick is in.
We do this shit every year, man.
I got my finger on the stream button. If it go dark, y'all know what it is.
Hey, man, you better not goddamn.
Hey, man, we have not discussed it. If it's off, we'll hit the stream, but if we out.
Hey, man, let's go, man. Let's go, Bird.
Idiots might pick another wide out.
They might. We'll see.
Oh, hell.
Like, no. They pick CD not. Lamb. Like, oh, yeah.
Don't play into that, Banks.
We're
hoping for better this year. Don't play into what he's saying over there.
Hey,
man.
Well, the one thing about it, didn't ask your ass.
Bro, I already gave my pick. I got some people agreeing with me out there. Chase Young.
I'm talking about Fees. I'm talking about Fees ass.
Yeah, Fees.
Today, we have a problem. A problem.
Golly.
I'm having a very bad day.
Golly, man.
What happened?
This ain't going in well.
Damn, let me fire up my stick. Hey, calm my nerve down.
Hey, my boy Talmadge say he from New Orleans. Well, that's even the reason why your shit fucked up, Talmadge. You an ain't
in out.
You an ain't
in out.
Hoax, he a hoax.
Y'all say go spell all that shit out for G-A-U-X. That shit just G-O. Y'all fucked up anyway.
Say what my girl from 300 say? This will not be over early, and you will not enjoy it.
Exactly, go.
Wow, man! Lord, this draft went left fast.
Oh, it's about to get ugly.
Get some dirt.
Hey, man, we got one vote out there to say Gary mute his mic.
Who they picking?
God say mute his fucking mic.
I mean, the Oakland Raiders really took Henry Ruggs.
Hey, I mean, do you really want to mute my mic?
Mm-hmm.
Then you'd be bored.
You see, y'all notice what I played for the Falcons pitch. We got to watch for the hook.
See, now I'm in there.
We got to watch for the hook with these guys, man.
Hey, everybody in this fight.
You could play something else, man. Welcome to Atlanta. This other shit you doing, you a hater, Bill.
It's about the fans tonight, baby.
No, you not no fan, though.
The hell you say?
Yes,
boy. Oh, y'all about to catch the hook.
Chicken Little ass fan.
This guy, he think he has the blueprint on fandom. You do not have the blueprint on fandom, good sir.
He doesn't.
Sean Powell, what it is.
Powell says it's going to be Chase Sun. Sean, we'll see. Sean, we'll see.
Yeah, I got a few people on the bandwagon.
Got a couple people out here that's agreeing with Mike Bell. That ain't a good sign, Sean. So
shit,
I don't know
me.
How you want to say it.
Clearly, he's a realist.
They say CeeDee Lamb, the best player on the board. Y'all going to pick him.
He the best available. Nah, we did that last 2 years ago with Ridley. We're not doing that this year.
We have a problem.
They're definitely not pick any offensive
player. Dan Quinn all by himself.
Not one.
Dan Quinn by himself.
Say what, Mace?
No offensive
players. Should pick no offensive players. Like, that would be utterly ridiculous to pick anybody on offense.
Not even offensive line.
You just picked two last year.
You got two last year. What the fuck? You don't need no
And
more.
You signed two in free agency.
Everybody keep talking about number two reason. He need offensive line.
The pick is in. The pick is in.
Some hating motherfuckers. I swear.
He just jumped in.
Picking little motherfuckers.
Dwight, that's what they said, right?
Hey, man, he is fine, man. Whatever. Let's get this
line.
Pick.
He'll have more time if he had offensive line.
Go get. If they don't get your boy Chase on, get AJ Terrell, man.
Here we go.
Brian Westlake.
What they gonna do?
Brian Westlake home.
AJ Terrell, Clemson.
Okay. That is Brian. Hey! Let's go Westlake. Let's go Westlake.
Let's go Westlake.
Hey, man, I just told you, motherfucker. Hey, man, if you ain't going with Chase, so let's go Westlake. Come bring the home team boy home.
Cowboys on the clock.
No matter who they pick, we're going to last.
Wow.
Hey, man, listen. I'm going to tell you something. Now, that's a trivia question for you. It probably in a high school in the fucking country got more NFL stars than Westlake High School. Them motherfuckers loaded over there, man.
Hey, man. They really just give his record as a starter. They don't ever count records for anybody but coaches and quarterbacks. Miss me with that.
Hey, man. And the crazy part about it, He wasn't even a stud on the team. The kid that went to Georgia was the kid that overshadowed him over at Westlake. Jaden Hunter.
Man, Jaden Hunter, what? No.
No, coming out of high school. AJ Terrell was like a 2 or 3 star. Jaden was
No.
What?
No, go look that up again. No.
I'm telling you now.
No, Jaden Hunter was getting by on name.
I know that, but AJ Terrell wasn't no goddamn 4-star coming out of
high
school.
Yes, he was. How you think he got the Clemson?
I mean, he just went first round.
How you think he got the Clemson?
I mean, the kid could ball. Don't get me wrong. I thought
AJ was damn near 5-star.
Was he?
Yeah, Jaden.
I didn't think he was.
Hunter. You know Jaden Hunter not at Georgia no more, right?
I know. Yeah, I know he transferred.
Yeah, he shouldn't have went to Georgia.
He should have never went there. That Kirby gave him the home team deal on that.
Well, we're going to welcome this guy to Atlanta style.
They must be rising up from hell because they've been rising up for about 50 years. How the hell far up you got to go?
I wanted D-line or a corner, so I ain't mad.
Oh, they got him at five. They got him at five. What up, dog? I didn't think he was rated that high coming out of that. Yeah, they got him at five.
Yeah, he was big time.
I ain't never seen nobody rise up so long.
AJ was recruited by every school in America.
Talmadge said AJ Terrell sucks. Jamar Chase toasted his ass in the damn
championship game.
Come on, man.
Jamar Chase caught 24 touchdowns. He was Biletnikoff winner. Stop.
Let's be clear about something, man.
Jamar Chase got 20 touchdowns.
Hey, man. Quarterback is goddamn. If not the single toughest position to play in fucking professional sports, man, in football, it's a cornerback.
Especially now with the way they treat the receivers,
Quarterback is the most difficult position in football.
No, it's not, man. You look at man. They made this shit a quarterback league now where you can't do certain things, you can't do this. So they get all this time in the world, and a corner has to stay out there in coverage for 5+ fucking seconds. And if you get burnt one time, just like your boy said, you got beat, da-da-da-da-da, woot-woot. Hey, man, that shit's a goddamn gruel every time you go out there.
Hey, man,
quarterback is easily the most difficult position in football, and there's no metric that you're going to put up that says that corner is more difficult than quarter. It might be second. Nothing is more difficult than being a quarterback and having to run the damn team.
You won't get no argument from me on that, but I know with the cornerbacks and the way they treat receivers now, it's very difficult for these guys. You can't be handsy anymore like you used to. You got to have your hands off. You can't touch these guys, man. It's way tougher for a cornerback in the NFL these days, man. That's a hell of a goddamn job to have.
It is tough, but for you to say it's the most difficult position in football is absolutely not.
I think it is.
It's almost like they force you to goddamn, like you almost got your hands behind your back.
He got some little yamage in his background, too. Got a little guy there. Oh, AJ Terrell. You know, he got a little.
But AJ locked down.
I thought you wasn't looking at the youngin'.
I can tell. He got the baby. He got that
little baby mama right there, but AJ locked down.
That Jerry Jones. Here we go.
Oh Lord, this is gonna make me cry right here, y'all.
Talk to me, Mace.
This hurts, baby. Let's go.
If we don't take no safety right here, I'm gonna be sick.
Quarterback, they gonna get a quarterback. The pick is in.
So Mace, talk to them before they go to.
What it better be Xavier McKinney.
They kicking it. They predicting CD Lamb. That's who they were looking at.
No, please don't be CD Lamb.
Yep.
Go ahead.
Now he's gonna get the other Oklahoma boy.
Oh, that girl he got sitting next to him is hot too.
Please don't be CeeDee Lamb. Please,
cowgirl fan.
House like that?
Please don't take CeeDee Lamb.
She like, oh, it's a camera in here.
Yeah. She got some gorgeous legs.
You got the heels strapped to the feet.
Yeah, beautiful legs.
I knew Gerald couldn't be at the crib by himself. So he gonna be at the house by himself. Stop, Gerald.
Yeah, Jared.
Why she got those 6-inch heels just sitting in the chair?
She letting you know, baby. It's going down.
CeeDee Lamb out here losing money, baby. He losing money.
Jared talking to
you. He got to take the Bentley truck back.
they finna get a wide receiver.
Mike McCarthy and Jerry Jones talking to each other.
Don't do it.
They finna get a wide
Steven,
receiver,
don't
bro.
Do it, Steven. Reconsider.
On a subject matter.
We do not have your back, dog.
You better get a receiver.
Hey man, listen. I'm telling y'all now. If we take a receiver. I'm telling y'all.
We got
you, I'm
a leg joined in live from Grandma's kitchen.
I'm gonna have to go pull the bottle off the top shelf. If we pick a receiver, dog.
Not a top shelf, bro.
This is gonna be all bad.
All bad?
This is gonna be all. If it's CeeDee Lamb, it's gonna be all
bad. Pick is in.
Here we go.
Mike McCarthy want a damn receiver, man. Look how he's looking. He want a damn receiver.
Look at it. Look at that motherfucker.
CeeDee Lamb.
CeeDee Lamb.
They got him. CeeDee Lamb. CD Lamb.
There you go. Wow. They picked CD for real.
Yeah, they did.
They should have got quarterback.
Hey, that must mean they finna goddamn get Dak this money.
Oh, Dak, listen.
You Dak, gotta get him another weapon.
Dak going from $2 million to $31 million next year. Dak ain't tripping, man. Dak gonna get paid.
Well, he ain't okay. signed his goddamn tender.
Yeah, got Dana Gordon like in the house. Done Woody and this thing. We can't celebrate our 20th anniversary because of the damn COVID, but we still here.
That's right. Petty Sports Edition 2020 NFL Draft brought to you by
King
Broadcasting. Thank you for joining the show tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Really appreciate it. Start that watch party. Let them know we're in the building. We got Macy Yo. We got Famous Fees, Dwight Banks, Petty Man, and Mike Bell, baby. And we going in on the draft.
Look at Macy.
You know what I'm saying? It's a lot going on. People sweating. Macy, people taking shots. You know what I mean? Hey, this is what it's about, ladies and gentlemen.
Macy said to have another drink. Don't get that top chef. You said they pick a wide receiver. You're going to get that top chef.
I took it off and put another Patriot hat on. When we get to pick number 23, I'm going to put the hat back on.
I can't even get out of the chair right now, dog. I can't even leave the studio right now.
God there damn, it is. Dog. You can't get up, bro.
I can't get up, dog. I'm disgusted right now.
Somebody in the chat room talking about, how about them Cowboys?
Well, how about them grabbing
this thing? How about the Cowboys? They picked the receiver, and they needed to get a quarterback because you don't actually have one.
They got a quarterback. They're going to stick with your boy. They're going to stick with Lack. They're going to stick with Lack Prescott.
You going to hold out?
Whack ain't going nowhere. Ain't nobody finna pay Whack.
Ooh, they back on shouting.
Old boy just took his phone from his girl.
Ooh, we right on national TV.
Who that? Who?
CD Lamb. The old girl had his phone. He took it out of hand like she was trying to read something he didn't want her to see.
She had that look on her face.
She all on the gram.
She had the look on her face like you just did that to me on national TV.
Michael Irvin all smiles.
CD got them breads on. Look, one thing about it, she ain't gonna trip. CD gonna chuckle and when they go to commercial break. He gonna pull it to the side like, look at him, shout it.
Just ride away.
I got these folks trying to call me. I don't need
you here to just look good. Like, don't touch my phone.
Ride the wave.
Don't touch my phone.
I got you. Look who here. You here.
You can't do that.
Them other hoes ain't here.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you the one that's here with me, baby. Right, goddamn.
Yeah, you the mother hoes don't mean that. You here, baby.
We took CD Lamb. Fellas, I'm about to go. Look at Mike Irvin. He's smiling. I'm going to go die a slow death, guys. I appreciate y'all, man.
We appreciate you for coming in, bro. Right
now, man. You still alive? Y'all. You a Cowboy fan. You've been dying a slow death for 25 years. You talking about you die today?
Hey. Yeah, no, that note. That's why Fees is my guy. I'm going to go fry the car, y'all.
All right. Y'all, man. Hey, take it easy, man. Appreciate it.
Boy. Yeah. Appreciate you.
All right. Yes, all right. Got Kendall in this thing.
All right. Crazy. So my man Talmadge Thomas.
Don't know what team he rooting for these days.
He said, so here's a question for y'all. Do y'all still believe in Matt Ryan leading y'all squad? Of course we do.
Hell no.
We ain't got no choice.
Don't listen to the motherfucker over here with the bullshit ass gay shirt on. I'm telling you right now, Talmadge.
You talking about the FUBU jerseys behind you? Is that what you mean?
I'm talking about the one with the ass ring in it. You.
The FUBUs?
So, Matt Ryan is still the guy. We ride with Matty Ice. He is our quarterback. We don't have no – we're not wavering like some of you motherfuckers.
This is my quarterback.
I'm assuming you're a Saints fan. You got Drew Brees for another year. He can't – you know, he's showing that his arm strength is going down. And now y'all got Taysom Hill behind him. Get the fuck out of here. You can leave us the fuck alone and worry about your own sorry ass beignet-eating motherfucking team.
Who's behind Matt Ryan?
It don't matter. We don't need about the motherfucker miss
one. You just mentioned who's behind
one
Drew
game
is
10
who's behind
years.
Matt Ryan.
He's an Iron Man. We play.
Stop.
Okay, well, okay. He fucking played. Listen, he's one of the highest sack rated quarterbacks in the league, and he still gets his ass up every day and goes out there. And
he leads out of nowhere every year. Congratulations.
Hey, Congratulations. You're absolutely right. You're a goddamn Tampa Bay Buccaneers fan.
I got somebody on my feed. FUBU. I got an upset Falcon fan on my feed. He said, what the fuck? We took a kid from Westlake that Justin Jefferson tore up in the championship game. Fire Dimitroff and Quinn now.
Again, that's the shit that motherfuckers look at. That kid is a 6'1 fucking cornerback.
That dude was scorching everybody.
And this league, where at feed so eloquently put it, you got three Hall of Fame quarterbacks in the division. That kid's a big physical fucking cornerback, and you just lost Lifeutt in the goddamn free agency. So you pick him up and he addressed the issue. Like I said earlier, if you don't pick a D lineman that's going to take some of the pressure off your young DB, you got to pick a top tier DB, and AJ Terrell fits that mold.
Mm. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, from our Queens English expert.
Queen's English expert. I mean, that actually is very fitting. You say it's the Queen's English because he speaks Falcon English, which would translate to Queen's English.
So, Talmadge, I take it you're a Saints fan. Let us know if you're a Saints fan or not. Because he said we're drafting Jordan Love. Let me ask what kind of sense does that fucking make?
We're not building for the future with a quarterback right now. We got at least two more years left. No,
we're talking about he's a New Orleans Saints guy. But you got Taysom Hill, so why the fuck would you pick Jordan Love? Unless you don't think Taysom Hill is
exactly,
the guy.
Exactly. He was mouthing off right a few months ago about him thinking he's one of the best quarterbacks in the league and all that kind of shit. So, you know what I mean? I feel him.
Talmadge, I understand, bro. You've been drinking too many of them Hurricanes and eating them dingoes. Right. Come on, man.
Dolphins pick is in.
The
Dolphins' second pick. They had the number 5 pick in the draft. They picked Tua, obviously. We'll see where this goes.
They're going to take another receiver off the board?
They're supposed to be getting Josh Jones, offensive tackle. Houston.
Okay.
They need to go ahead and pick up T. Higgins.
And then the Raiders come back into this thing. See what Gruden has up his sleeve.
And then Jacksonville again. Like, man, all these teams have been stacking picks.
Yeah, they got a lot of picks. Hell, fucking Vikings got 2 in this round, too.
No, we're going to see what they do. Craziness. But, you know, I still always got some more for you.
What's up, Gemini AV? Appreciate you joining.
You're like, everybody chiming in the chat rooms. Need y'all to chime in and let us know who your team is.
Yeah, hey, let's go.
Put some skin in the game.
Don't sit around and talk about other teams. Let us know who your team is.
Rep your team. Everybody rep your team in the chat room.
Yeah, rep your own team. 871.
Give us a call. 678.
871.
9602.
Yeah.
Hey, man.
Curtis Combs, I see you. Sheila Hamilton, I see you out there. DeAndre, what's good?
What's up, Catchy?
D-Dot Herbert?
Yeah, we
don't
hear
that.
Seth?
Oh, yeah. D-Dot is Who Dat Nation.
Yeah. JR, I see you out there. Black Tony on deck.
Black Tony on deck. See, I was going to come in, man.
Black Tony, he don't dig down. He'll use all his vacation.
I had a flat tie.
Hey, Black Tony, what you think about our pick, man? Tell us what you think about our pick that the Falcons just made. You like it? You buying or selling? What you think, man?
Okay.
Dang, who did Miami get? Shit, who they get?
They got an offensive tackle from USC, Austin Jackson.
Austin Jackson.
Damn. First Trojan off the board.
Offensive tackle?
Yeah.
300.
We know y'all are Pac-12 haters. So y'all are like, I have no idea who that is. He a Trojan. It's a good pick.
He's a big motherfucker.
That he is. It's a reason he went early.
Okay, he donated bone marrow. Okay, I'm saying to his sister.
To his sister. Okay, I'm glad he said that. I'm gonna say, oh shit. These other goddamn old corporate guys.
What are these Rays gonna do, man?
These corporate guys.
What are they gonna do, man?
Ronnie Davis, appreciate you tuning in. Sean Power.
Oh, we getting closer. Waiting on number 23.
Who is this? Sean Powell. I would like to see Grenard in the second.
Is that the kid from Florida? I think he's from Georgia too, if I ain't mistaken. I don't know if that's who he's talking about. And he's, I think Sean Powell's the Falcon fan. Sean, are you with the Falcons or who you with?
He might not even got no pick. He's just out here just talking.
Well, we're going to give the benefit of the doubt, old goddamn hater of men. you hell on everybody. They motherfuckers don't goddamn profess they goddamn love for the dark side in New England. You just goddamn dog everybody out.
Hey, I mean, if you got something to say, then I need you to come with some weight behind it.
The man just said, I would like to see Grenard in the second. So maybe he's talking about the Falcons picking the D. If it's the edge rush out of Florida, that's maybe who he's talking about. You like, he ain't got no team. God damn. There's other teams out there other than goddamn cheating-ass Patriots.
How the hell? See, we got folks say, I'm too shy to call in, but my heart team is the Steelers and home too state is the Falcons.
Call in.
Hey, you too shy to call in. Wait. First and foremost,
all we doing is talking football.
Hey, as a duly elected Falcon delegate, if you live in Atlanta, born and raised in Atlanta, your team is the Steelers, we don't want to hear from your fucking ass in the first place. How about that?
See, that's why people don't want to call in. You and Fees got these motherfuckers scared.
They don't want to hear from you.
You and Fees got people scared to call in, man.
Y'all be clowning me for they don't want to call in. They scared,
y'all scared people out the pettis court.
You need to defend your honor.
What's up, Emmanuel Thrash? Who you like, Emmanuel Thrash? Who you like out there? Who's your team, man? Did they make the right pick?
I'm just messing with you, Steelers fan. Does the Steelers have a pick in the first round anyway? No, they don't.
No.
Hey, so you can call in. Y'all ain't picking in the first round anyway.
They're out of it today. Yeah. The Steelers are out of it today just like they were in the playoffs the last 2 years.
All right, so that's a big boy that Dolphins just picked up.
Raiders pick is
Hey, wait. Hey, y'all see the little cutie with him. She don't look nothing like his family. That boy. Go ahead, my boy.
Hey, I mean, you're going to the league. You should be winning.
So Sean Powell said he Falcons all the way. So yeah, I guess he's talking about the Florida guy, man, the edge rush out of Florida that he's referring to. Jonathan Grenard, I think Jonathan Grenard is his name, if I ain't mistaken. So we'll see now. Hey, man.
Let's see what they get. The Raiders, here we go.
Y'all damn Falcons going to fade out faster than the FUBU jerseys y'all wearing.
Yep, that's what you said. Raiders, you on that shit, boy. And I realize, you was a hater.
Fees, we throwing the flag on you,
that's
man.
That's new Raiders stadium right there. Ain't it?
That motherfucker look pretty nice.
Big motherfucker.
Nice.
They finished it?
The number is 678-871-9602, Talmadge Thomas. Man, they ain't Talmadge.
Call in. Get it off your chest. Let us know what's really happening.
Oh, yeah, you call in, say what you want to say. I promise you.
Damon Arnett, cornerback from Ohio State.
Damon Arnett.
More Buckeyes.
Damon, sorry about that. Damon Arnett.
He's fucking the goddamn kid's name up. You ain't shit.
Man, I'm not an expert in the Queens.
Yeah, you like the dude at the graduation screwing up the name, just messed up their whole moment for their whole life.
Damon, motherfucking Damon.
Well, I did catch myself. Shit.
Damon. He black. Damon.
Sorry, we're getting closer. We almost to pick number 23.
Why? Because you motherfuckers is horrible.
We're running out of time, man. We about to get all.
I mean, we better than y'all.
What you said it for this time, G? Another for 11 o'clock?
No, the Patriots coming up, so we about to run out of time.
The kid cut that shit short, G. Cut it short.
The network running short, man.
The network don't like that shit. Hey, Talmadge, you asked for the number in between your beignets and your hurricane. Give us a call.
Okay.
I want to talk to my boy.
You got the number going across the bottom of the screen. The number to call in to the studio and holler at the Petty Sports crew is at the bottom of the screen, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, Hey, man, tell him call on in.
Yeah, you heard that. You motherfucking Queens English ass buffer.
Hey, my man, Okie D, a.k.a. Texas Toast, said there are 192 wide receivers in the NFL. Only 8 of them have been Biletnikoff winners. You're not
We got a call. We got a call.
Biletnikoff winners every game.
We got a call coming in on the petty line.
But I went and did it a little research.
That's a hell of a stat.
Hey, what it do? What's happening? Who we got on the Petty Sports line tonight? You at the table with the crew. Who we got on the line?
You got Talmadge Thomas. You wanted him, you got him.
Hey, speak your mind then, good sir. Speak your mind. What say you about the draft 2020 edition here on Petty Sports?
Like, he want to say some shit.
You breaking up, man.
Come on, Beignet boy.
Division the last 3 years.
He out there with that T-Mobile, man. What the hell going on?
What happened in the division the last 3 years?
Hold on, we can't hear you. Say what you say again. Repeat, please.
I said, I got love for y'all, man, but division for the last 3 years.
I no comprende. I mean, what you mean?
You say y'all won a division for the last 3 years, Beignet boy?
Can you hear me?
I hear you, but it didn't really make sense to me.
What are you saying?
I said the Saints been running the division the last 3 years.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Okay, like the last three times you said it, you left the Saints out.
If you look at the last 2 years, we done won the division the last 9 years, we done won the division 4 times out of the last 9 years. And after we win it this year, we'd have been won it 5 times.
Well, wishful thinking.
I mean, that's
sir.
Not impressive.
That's wishful thinking. Yeah, it is. I mean, you came up like the Falcons, empty in the Super Bowl. You didn't get no Super Bowl.
So we have a Super Bowl.
Y'all got one.
Yeah, they got one. But I'm just saying,
congratulations,
like, all those division wins. He
that was the best you had to come. You came with your chest poked out to the damn stars for perseverance, and now you talking about we won 4 divisions in. 5 in 9 years.
Beignet boy.
Is that it?
So listen here, Beignet boy.
Have but like 3
I can make a better argument for the Saints than you.
Okay, listen. Y'all keep losing to the goddamn Vikings, and then y'all lost to the Ram in between those years. And what is your point because y'all won a division?
But I want to know how y'all feel Matt Ryan can lead y'all.
We fine with Matt Ryan, just like y'all feel like goddamn Drew Brees can lead y'all.
Division in. When last time the Falcons won a division?
Last time the Falcons won to be 2016. I'm sorry. What you want to know? Before that, well, I think it was 2012. Carolina won it in between that, and then y'all won it this time. It goes in spurts. I'm sorry, Beignet boy. I'm lost in what you're
trying hung to up. Say. He hung up.
All right, dog. You can't. You can hang up, but you still listening, Beignet boy.
He didn't have a point.
He fall with your chest stuck out. Like, he got this. I'm about to tell you.
Hey, he was on that Metro PCS. That's
right. Like, get off them goddamn hurricanes with this bullshit you talking about the last 3 years.
You say Feezy didn't make a point? You still trying to figure out what his point was?
And y'all still suing, motherfucker.
I don't know what the hell you trying to say.
What the fuck, Beignet boy?
Yeah, he had a few too many or something before he called in.
Get the fuck out of here, Beignet boy.
He was looking confused. He was like, I mean, what is he saying?
Carlton Wilson say Cowboys trying to outscore everybody.
Hey, Darrell Harris Jr., welcome to the show, brother. Appreciate you checking in, man. God. Hey, man, y'all give us a call.
678-871-9602.
It's the fans versus
Steve. Not in the house.
Let's go, man. Hey, come in with your fandom. Tell us who they should pick. Fee's going to tell you why you fucked up and wrong. We just had Beignet boy call in.
What up, Ronnie Davis?
I couldn't even tell him why he was wrong because I don't know what the hell he was saying.
Hey, my man,
if you call in, please at least make sense.
Did he sound like the coach for LSU?
He's not like the damn water boy.
Hey, Leon Brooks said they lost the last 3 years by big plays, too. LO exact. And they're going to sue. They're going to sue the NFL when they lose again. Who gives a fuck, Beignet boy? Stop playing.
Yeah, they're going to not watch the Super Bowl when they don't play in it again.
And file lawsuits. Fuck out of here, Beignet boy.
Put up more billboards in the city. I guess Tampa needs to be on the lookout for more Saints billboards in their city.
What the hell is Beignet boy? What's that, man?
The little beignet, the little dessert they serve in the
little sugary little donut thing.
Little sugar goddamn little pastry.
You call beignet, the damn, beignet boy. You call the dude a
dessert. You don't know what a beignet is? I mean, I don't eat them, but I know what they are.
Hey, man. Oh, yeah. Hey, man. Hey, listen. Hey.
I eat little Debbie's. I eat little Debbie's.
They not even quite little. They fancy. They fancy a little. I'm going to get you a picture, Joe. Hey, Tavis. It's all love, bro. We're just fucking with you. But you root for the Aints, man. So you can't call them that.
Oh, he said the reception was bad.
Oh, that's what it is, beignet boy. Okay, then. We thought you had that powdered sugar on your lips.
Nah, he just got sprint. That's all.
Sprint it on up out of here, right?
Let's go, man.
I'm pretty sure that is what he said. He got sprint. That's why his service sucks.
Jacksonville's pick is in.
How many damn picks they had?
You said Jacksonville, like they jacking off of something like
Jacksonville.
Yeah, like,
who they bringing in to play with Gardner Minshew? They just got rid of Marquise Lee, and he signed with the Patriots. No, they're taking they sweet time with this one. Like, come on, man. We know who the best available is. Who they picking?
Jacksonville, you know.
Jason still on the board, man. I'm surprised.
How is Jordan Love on this board as the best available and Hurts ain't?
Boy, you gotta ask that question. You really gotta ask that question.
They might get Chaseon.
I mean, I do have to ask that question.
Well, they need a D lineman. And
they got an outside linebacker, Clavion Chasen. Told you.
Clavion Chasen.
Chaseon.
Clavon, my bad. I messed it up again.
There you go. I know you fucking up.
Oh yeah, you good at tearing up the name. Hey, you fucking up. Teacher to say everybody's name wrong.
Hey, Aaron. Hey, Balake.
I'm gonna lose my mind.
Hey, Balake.
Balake.
God damn,
boy. Balake, I know you hear
Mike Bell, goddamn. My IK.
But I'm good with coming back correcting my shit, right?
No, call it what you want to. I don't know if that's true or not. We'll see. Yes, sir, my brother Talman. We appreciate you checking in and calling, man.
Eagles on the board.
Even though, oh, the Eagles, man. I got a couple people out. My man D. Wells out there is a big-time Eagles fan.
They're supposed to be picking a wide receiver.
We'll see what they're going to do, man, with that thing.
Yeah, like who left? Judy's gone. Ruggs is gone. Lamb is gone. The Eagles probably going to pick Jefferson right here. I can see that happening.
They going to pick who?
Jefferson at LSU. They need a wideout. I mean, even when DeSean Jackson comes back, they pick up Jefferson. That just makes the attack that much more versatile.
They'll mess around and get Jalen Rigor.
Who's that?
Jalen Rigor?
Yeah.
He's from Texas Christian.
You must know him personally.
He on the board, though. I'm just saying,
they've
been flip-flopping. You know, that's how some of the picks have flip-flopped.
Hey,
like
man, did you just pull a motherfucker from Texas Christian?
I'm like, really? Like, how the hell you know the names of players that play for Texas Christian?
Hey, Mike Mayock.
He on the board.
Mike Mayock. And what was it that he played, Mike Mayock?
He wide receiver, sir.
Hey, Mike Mayock.
Mike Mayock.
Yeah, boy, you went deep with that shit, man. Come on, Mike Mayock.
They crazy, man.
Hey, that's his new name for you, Mike Mayock.
Mike Bell, baby.
No, Mike. Yeah,
you done graduated from Bobby Bell to Mike Mayock.
Mike fucking Mayock with this shit.
Because you don't even know who that guy is. You ain't ever even watched him do highlights.
My guy.
Aaron.
Aaron.
I'm like, I wasn't even going to sit here in front like I know who you were talking about. Like, who?
Hey, man.
All right, when they pick his ass, then what y'all going to say?
If it dares that, you the guy. You the motherfucking guy.
You know, you read somebody else's mock draft and regurgitated it.
They ain't about to
pick Jefferson.
I picked two tonight, so I'm good.
I mean, everybody picked the first five. Congratulations.
This guy here.
They literally went in order where everybody thought they would go.
So wait, Greg Robinson, who you rolling with? We don't know who you said. You missed the pick. Who we get? Who you rolling with, Greg?
Eagles
pick is in. What you said, Fees, Justin Jefferson, you think they're going to go stick with it?
Yeah. That's what I got on deck for them boys.
They got Grant. Boy, got them fat little jerseys, fat t-shirts over there. Odell pick.
That's what they on the phone with him. He on the phone, so, looking like it's going to happen.
Justin Jefferson.
Mad y'all be in front of me like that. Like y'all literally see the pick before I do on every single one of them.
Yeah, I'm so far behind. Like I can hear somebody's TV. So we're using a
phone in this store. Is that a good idea? I don't know. Maybe it's a YouTube TV. Maybe a little bit ahead. I don't know.
I'm streaming mine anyway. I'm streaming mine.
Yeah, I am too.
Through ABC.com.
Yeah, Irvin rocking that fro, goddamn.
Yeah, I can't even see Michael Irvin.
Look, I'm on Hulu Live.
Oh, okay.
I'm ahead of you, but I'm behind them.
Michael Irvin got these guys wearing these pinstripe suits. Yeah, it's crazy, man. I don't really want pinstripe suits and shit.
Let's get it.
Yeah, Michael Irvin out there with that Pookie style.
Damn, man, I'm surprised we didn't see
Eagles pick is in.
Tyrone Bigum style.
Yeah, where LJ at?
Man, she ain't come in today.
Well, I don't know where LJ at. LJ might have to work tonight, goddamn. She don't miss no sports
stuff. She don't miss no sports stuff like this. Did she come on yesterday?
I can't recall.
I hadn't seen her since Sunday.
No. I mean, I know she liked the...
She did like the video? That yesterday's show?
Yeah, like the little joint for the day.
Oh, okay.
She must be busy.
Probably working.
Why is pick taking so long? They say the pick is in. They said it's in for like 10 minutes.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Philadelphia. Give me the pick.
Me boy got the same step and repeat board behind them. Look at that. They ain't want to look at it. Got the same little Philly fly shit behind them.
I don't care what they got going on. Make your pick so we can move.
Come on, Howie Roseman.
Yeah, I could have 11:30.
Huh? What?
Yeah.
Really?
What do you say at 11:30?
Why don't they show the Knicks?
We own to about 11:30.
11:30. I hope we make it. We got how many picks we got left?
We should get to the Patriots at least, and maybe the Saints.
So let me ask you a question, because maybe I'm silly, right?
You must Jalen Rigor.
Y'all didn't look at the broadcast to see how long it's gonna go.
I was one off, Jalen Rigor.
What do you mean you were one off?
The receiver from TCU. That's who the Eagles just picked.
Okay, but that's not what you call. How you one off, though?
Well, I mean, shit, though.
Damn,
baby. I mean, explain that. How you one off?
They didn't get who we thought he was going to get.
But where the one off come in at? So the guy you picked going to go next?
No, he just got picked.
So you won one off then? What the fuck? You just wrong.
No.
See, here we go. Go ahead.
I'm gonna leave that alone, but I'm not doing this with you, sir.
Thank you, because I remember he won off.
I mean, did you say he was going there?
Well, his dad played for the Colts.
I had him going to. I thought he JVL might grab him.
Oh, okay. So what the hell are you talking about?
Well, like I said, I was one off. They need a wide receiver, so I mean, they were predicted to go Justin Jefferson.
Right. Minnesota. But man, Crooked King asked you, TCU kid. There you go.
Okay.
Oh no, I was right, actually. My bad. Shit.
No, you weren't.
Yes, I was. I was right.
Well, hey, Crooked King, who's your team? Oh well.
TCU. Who we got on?
Crooked King asked you. TCU. He must be a Texas fan.
Sorry, Minnesota up.
Yeah.
And then them boys is picking.
Minnesota AK coming.
They probably gonna pick
up AKA the Aints Killer.
Pick up.
Number 23 is coming. Yeah, the Aints Killer is picking right now.
All right, so Feed, while we're waiting on that.
The Falcons Killer is coming after that.
Give us your rundown on what you think your New England Patriots are and who they're going to go with.
I mean, it's hard to say. Man. I mean, if I had to do what I wanted to do, I'd say we take a quarterback right now. I really want to take Jalen Hurts. I don't think they will do it because we never do what we want to do. Like, Bill has a whole nother agenda for everything. But as far as what we look like, N'Keal Harry will be healthy this year. We just picked up Marquise Lee. Still got Mohamed Sanu, Julian Edelman. The two tight ends are garbage. The defense is still, for the majority, is still intact. We let a couple of pieces go over there. What I can see happening is we'll probably pick up somebody on the defense, like somebody to replace Kyle Van Noy, somebody to replace Shelton. It's going to be somebody on the defensive side, even though everyone feels like we need a quarterback and we're not going to do it.
Okay.
I think you guys' offensive line is pretty depleted too, right?
No, like they were hurt. Like the offensive line and the wide receiver core all was pretty much hurt off and on the whole season. Like all of them coming back healthy, they don't need to address all of that. Like we need a quarterback. I mean, I don't think they say that Jared Stidham is looking really good and they're high on him. I don't believe that. If we stay with Jared Stidham, I say we only gonna win 5 games next year. We bring in another quarterback, then we might actually at least be able to catch that 7th playoff spot since they added one. Mm-hmm.
What up, Sheila Hamilton? Good Whalen and Sherman Wood. Thank you for joining the show tonight. Petty Sports 2020 Draft Edition brought to you by Kings Broadcasting Studio. We appreciate you guys tuning in. Start that watch party. Share it with somebody.
We won't have to play the Saints and the Bucks twice a year, so we're in better shape than the Falcons.
So you say that? So okay, goddamn. You say y'all need to choose a defensive lineman? You said?
No, I say we probably will either pick a defensive lineman to replace Shelton or a linebacker to replace Kyle Van Noy or Jamie Collins. So, but I want a quarterback.
It's funny you say that because during the combine or right before the combine, Bill Belichick actually took a visit down to Middle Tennessee State University.
Yeah.
To look at an impressive defensive end named Tyshawn Render and did a full-blown workout with him. So that might be in, you know, maybe his chess move or what have you. But that kid is, you know, one of those kids that people say he is the next freak of nature.
But I doubt he drafted him that high.
Yeah, well, you just never know. Bill Belichick may know something everybody else doesn't know. But hey, my man Demetrius Wells checking in. Hot ashes.
What up, D Wells?
What up, D Wells? I'm trying to get your pick, man. Get you to call in and tell us what you thought the Eagles were going to do.
Are you happy with the pick? Are you happy with the pick, D Wells? What you think? Crooked King ask you.
Say Minnesota's pick is in. Who they got? Can we hurry up and get Minnesota out the way so we can see what the Sith Lord is going to do today?
Right.
I wouldn't be surprised if it came through and it'd been like, we traded the pick and we ain't even picked no damn body.
Fuck around and get a quarterback. Watch and see. I wouldn't be surprised if you get a
damn quarterback. We'll trade and get 2 second round picks. Be like, here we go.
But what do you think Minnesota needs right now? I mean, they got their, obviously got their franchise quarterback.
They need another receiver because they let Diggs go.
They let Diggs go. We understand that. So receivers, their top priority coming into this thing.
Supposedly a cornerback.
Between Jefferson, Pittman, Higgins, they need to pick up another top flight receiver.
Supposedly they're in the market for a cornerback. AJ Terrell from Clemson.
Oh, yeah. Terrell, let Xavier Rhodes go too.
You know AJ Terrell with the Falcons, Mike.
Yeah, y'all did just pick him. I mean, your team picked him, and you still are.
I said that's what they were in the market for. I didn't say that's who they was going to pick. They were in the market for a cornerback.
He's gone.
So they may still be looking for another corner.
Hey, man, what the fuck?
Look at the breed. They're killing Breeze ass.
Oh, damn, now they showing all the Minnesota versus Saints games.
My man D. Wells say, I was hoping we chose a linebacker, but I love the pick. Okay. We need a as well. Go Eagles. Like, cool. Hey, stand behind your team.
He happy with the pick. That's what's good.
Hey, man, are y'all opening up tomorrow? What y'all doing? You know, the governor of Georgia has relaxed the shelter-in-place rules. So I'm just trying to see if y'all will open it up tomorrow down there. How that is
in the movie. Y'all going out there doing bowling alleys and movies and shit.
Yeah, I go around there. You know, cigars kill Corona.
Yeah. Cigars do? I missed that memo.
Yeah. They don't want you to know.
That's because you're not woke, my brother. You're not woke.
Right. Okay, you take your woke ass down there and pass out in the middle of the street.
Oh, man. Die standing up.
So, D-Wells, let us know if y'all opening up tomorrow, man, and what y'all plans are, man.
How long has this pick been in? Come on, Minnesota. Big get out my face.
I know y'all doing grabbing goals, but let us know.
And they want to show all the glitz and glam. Here we go. Here we go. Here he is.
God damn, they drew
the make y'all pick and get out the way.
Got 30 minutes.
It ain't them, man. It's the NFL selling it, man.
Man, they stopped the countdown, but the pick's been in for like 8 minutes.
You see Goodell playing cheerleader.
Kept the countdown going. I wouldn't even be tripping.
Here we go. He calling it out.
Download Robinhood now. Justin Jefferson.
Wide
receiver. Told you they needed a wideout.
He's called it.
I just told you they need to replace Stephon Diggs.
Oh, here come the damn Patriots. I go piss right now since they ain't got shit anyway.
Oh, man.
You can go wherever you want to go. Let me bring my hat back. Yeah.
Oh, that dude wilder, man. Wilder,
yeah. Man. See who we going to pick up. Patriots on the clock, baby. Look at this. Oh, just that fact. I told you they was going to do it. We traded a pick to the Chargers. Stop it.
Wow.
Wow.
Yeah, I just said, I'm like, man, we're going to trade the pick, and we ain't even going to pick nobody.
God damn.
As soon as we got on the clock, we traded the damn pick.
To the Chargers. The Chargers don't.
They made a pick at number 6, so okay.
Why are they not giving us the terms of any of these trades? Like, what did we get for that? I mean, did we get Tyrod Taylor? Did we get a second round pick?
It sounds like the Sith Wolves got a damn plan.
We get like multiple picks. Like, what just happened?
Damn.
Looks like the Patriots ain't picking the first round.
Man, he shocked the world with that because,
I legit just told you. I'm like, man, I wouldn't be surprised if we just traded the damn pick and ain't picked nobody.
Exactly right.
As Minnesota's pick came in, it was like Patriots trade their pick.
Damn. Yeah, Banks. See that? The Patriots traded the pick, like Fee said.
Yeah, it is. They
They gave it to the Chargers. They got a report said that Jerry Jones wins the best NFL draft war room. It's on his $250 million yacht.
But hey, what did we get for trading that pick?
Social distancing at its best, right there, Jerry Jones.
Yeah. Always.
Why
are
they giving us the terms of nothing?
Well, probably not disclosed as of yet. Because everything now is kind of goddamn, you know,
Chargers
out in the open.
Let's see what Chargers do with it.
Chargers pick. Oh, they already made the choice. Okay.
Damn, so Patriots ain't going to pick this round. I mean, it's, yeah.
We don't have a second round pick, and now we traded our first round pick. So we must have got a second round and something else for that.
Maybe the Chargers gave up their second round pick.
But they ain't let us know what we got for it, though.
Oh, shit. Who is this? Going out there with the sun and fun.
So what else the Chargers need? They just picked Herbert. They got rid of Gordon. They might go ahead and take Jonathan Taylor right here.
So they got the quarterback need.
They get a second round pick. Okay, they traded the 23rd overall pick, and they got a 2020 second round pick and a third round pick.
A second and a third. I told you, like, we must have got a second and something else.
For this year, you said? For this year, Mike, 2020?
2020, yeah.
They got two picks, the third and the,
I mean, yeah, there it is.
Yeah.
is we got a second and a third round pick. So, I mean, now we have 13 picks instead of 12. We have a lot of picks.
And the way the Sith Lord looks at it is, it's not the first couple of rounds. He didn't really need it to rebuild. So, hey, he doesn't need the big splash in the pan either. He just needs the pieces that fit into his system.
I wonder, is he eyeing a quarterback? That's what I want to know.
Well, the run on quarterback is stopping. If what we're saying is true, that he likes From, Jalen Hurts is still there.
Man, if you don't get out of here, there. From nonsense.
Well,
hey, that'd be crazy. Hey, but shit, he talking about From and goddamn Sith Lord pick him up, right?
You get From.
Hey, Hurts is still out there. Jacob Eason is still out there. Jake from State From is still out there. I mean,
I'll take Hurts. I'll take Eason. I do not want From.
Hey, okay. But, you know, Sith Lord didn't ask your shit, though. He didn't ask either shit.
Oh, he did. It's like Sith Lord be watching.
He be watching you?
You don't know all the stats I be coming with? He be listening to me.
That is. I like your shit. I like how you put that shit. Keep drinking in, my brother.
Joy and Love. They got this. That's who they picked.
Who that?
Chargers.
Chargers? Yep. Whoa.
But wait, didn't they pick Herbert?
Yes.
No,
they didn't do it yet.
They're stockpiling quarterbacks now?
No, they trade. Okay, they trade.
My bad. That's wrong information. Wrong information.
Hey, what the fuck, Mike Bell?
What are you talking about, man? Like,
it popped up on the screen. It popped up on the screen.
Mute him.
They got the Kenneth Murray.
Inside linebacker, Oklahoma.
Somebody mute him.
If we didn't mute you, good sir, for all that bullshit you went ranting on about my squad.
Yeah, say it one more time. Media fucking obligation.
You've been wrong by everything.
I mean, goddamn.
Somebody got to be wrong sometimes.
That man just hit Jordan Love. Like, what the fuck, huh?
Kenneth Murray.
Like, just because they showed him didn't mean they picked him.
That's what it looked like. It looked like they picked him.
That's what they said. It looked like that. She looked like a girl, but she was actually a man. Doesn't mean you're not gay.
If I fuck her, that's a whole nother story.
Yeah. Oh.
I'm done with you, dog. I'm done with you.
He right here like pre-op or post-op. All right,
we got the stakes.
Hey, he asked them questions up front. Like, where we at with this whole process?
Oh, quagmire face ass.
So where we at in this whole process? Are you pre-op or you post-op? I'm just asking because I need clarification.
Stinks on the goddamn clock.
I need clarification. Who on the clock?
Stanks. Ain't the who that, the blue that.
So, Thomas Tabman, you never said who you guys are going to pick. Let me know who you guys are going to pick or who you think you guys should pick. We got a couple out there. Christy's Nikita.
You asked Bell. Bell will tell you the same spot to pick Chase Young.
Hey, man, Demetrius say.
Don't matter. You already been picked. That's who he said they're going
to
pick.
You see what D-Well said, Banks? They sticking to the.
Mike, he said that 20 minutes ago.
Oh, I didn't know you saw it because you left, man.
I replied to him already.
Okay.
But listen, I'll tell you, boy, this shit got damn rough.
Damn it. Man, the Saints going to pick a DB. They probably take, like Dale Pitt or something.
If they know like the Falcons know, they'll pick something in that secondary.
They don't need anybody on offense.
That's my whole thing. The offense, the last thing they need. You got Kamara at wide. I mean, at running back. You got Thomas at wide out.
Emmanuel Sanders.
Yeah, you got Emmanuel Sanders. So they don't need anything on offense. So your defense, you know, be it middle up the middle to stop the run. I don't know where they failed last year against the run defense and sell cornerback, right?
I mean, with what the division is presenting, you need DBs.
You better pick up DBs.
You need a lot of DBs.
Or linebackers that can run because, you know, if you want to look at it, you got Gronk now in this thing. And you got to have that fast, physical linebacker that can cover that cornerback as well.
Yeah, it looked like they're going to take their whole 4 minutes, too. So, I mean, looking at where people have already gone at this point, man, who do y'all think has been placed in the best position to be sitting pretty for rookie of the year so far?
Well, you figure what was the win total last year for Cincinnati?
I don't know. They were terrible, but I don't know what the record was.
So if you figure on that alone, if they come in and add four wins to Cincinnati, which is a hard thing to do, don't get me wrong, you know, Burrow will be that guy.
I don't know. Chase Young might.
I mean, Chase Young comes in and beats and put up, and put up sacks. That's not 16, a bad pick.
15, 16 sacks this year. Yes, I think he will be that guy. Right? But chances are he's going to be an offensive guy that makes that hit, right? So yeah. You handle it in the running backs and what a running back fall and what kind of system they fall into yet. So we don't know, you know, what that's going to look like as well. I think San Francisco has the 31st pick. They don't need a running back at all, but I wouldn't be surprised, you know, what Shanahan does as far as bolstering up his offensive side of it. Minnesota, they already picked a wide out.
Miami. Jefferson to Minnesota is going to be to have a strong campaign since, I mean, mm-hmm. like Thielen's out there. So he's not going to be the number one guy, and they do have a pretty potent offense, and he's going to be open.
I like what you put on the screen, Petty Man. On the clock, the Stanks.
Hey, Jared, you say
Maria in the house. Juan is bailing there.
It should have goddamn gotten kind of tight for some of these you know, quarterbacks. You only have a couple of them that go out in the first round. What do you feel at this point with only a few teams left in the draft right now? Right, the Saints mm-hmm. doesn't need one. Minnesota doesn't need a quarterback. Miami's already taken one. Seattle doesn't need a quarterback. Baltimore doesn't need a quarterback. Tennessee just traded out their guy and got one in. They like Green Bay. Doesn't need a quarterback. San Fran, maybe. And because of just how your boy Garoppolo fared last year in the playoffs in the Super Bowl, they may look to bring in somebody to shore up that piece of it.
That was just really his
and
first
Kansas
full
City
season.
Doesn't need a quarterback. Have we seen all the quarterbacks for this first round?
I don't think so.
I mean, it's highly likely no more will come off today.
Yeah. Who else needs one?
None of them.
Not a one.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Not to be picked first round, they don't.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it could always happen with one of these teams trade up.
Yeah. I mean.
But just in the current order, no.
Well, the only team out of the last remaining picks that I can say may need a quarterback is Green Bay.
Yeah, they need somebody as a successor, but I don't know if they'll pick them in the first round.
Yeah, that's the only thing about it. I don't know if they'll spend a first-round pick on them because everybody's still left, right?
I mean, A-Rod might outplay somebody's rookie contract.
And then what you have left, if you look at Discount Double Check's record, he has a losing record against teams that are above 500. I don't know if he's going to do that. And then in 2009 or 10,
he could last another 4 or 5 years and make a decision.
So you got rid of McCarthy. You brought in, who's it? The culture there? The Shanahan clone. The boy we had here should have been our
LaFleur.
You know, so now how many years? Because I don't think LaFleur is going to stick around because they were already antsy. Bringing LaFleur in, it had some headbutting issues. LaFleur said that Aaron Rodgers wasn't going to be able to change players at the line of scrimmage, yada, yada, yada. I'm not sure that LaFleur sold on Aaron Rodgers to run his scheme of offense. So now you got to look at it and say, hey, man, we got to do something about that. Crooked King asked you, say, quarterback for the Saints. Why do y'all, you and Talmadge, said the same shit. So I guess somebody other than Sean Payton don't believe in Taysom Hill. Like, nobody believes in Taysom Hill except for Sean Payton.
Clearly.
Y'all ain't about to draft no damn quarterback.
I mean, Crooked King, talk to me. Give us a call,
678-871-9602.
And tell us why you feel like the Aints should pick a quarterback. Because, damn, Sean Payton done bet the farm on him. And y'all let already ready Teddy get the fuck up out of there. And go to your division, no left.
Big boy crying.
Man, I'm still mad crying. We ain't picked nobody.
Is he already crying? God damn, he boo-hooing.
Who was that?
I don't know who this guy is.
Big old dude. These, hey, Fee, these are kind of like the spoilers in the movie that have already seen the shit.
Yeah, I'm like, you know you're ahead of us.
New Jersey. Big black crime. Big black crime.
Y'all gonna see it. I mean, he can't even really, he done lost his composure, man.
Oh, shit, it's a
Cesar Ruiz. Center
who
from
is
Michigan.
This big dude?
Center from Michigan.
That's what the Saints got. They got a center out of Michigan.
I love it.
Oh,
man.
Well.
Offensive guard is center out of Michigan.
Listen, when you got.
Well, I mean, that go back to something that I talked to y'all about a couple of weeks ago when I was talking about the discrepancy in where games are played at. And how NFL teams look at it, they take teams from Big Ten conferences, like from teams that play up north because they play up north. They need people to thrive in this cold weather. That's where the hell you got to play at in January when it counts.
Right.
Once you get past the freakish athletes that go in the beginning of the first round, now you're looking at who fits what you do.
Come on, big boy.
Hey.
Yeah.
I meant Ruiz. Not really.
Man, let me tell you something, man. When you look at it like this, man, 31 career starts out of 36 games played. You know, kid really, truly, man, got an opportunity to get to the league. And he's saying to himself, man, I'm there. My mind to make.
First
like,
round.
Those tears of joy right there are amazing.
Yeah, hard work paying off.
Yeah, that's what you want to see, man. Like, you know, at the end of the day, so many people betting on you, so many people sacrifice for you to do what you can do.
Mm-hmm. Show how humble it is.
Yeah.
You know how hard it is to get there.
Yeah.
That's you talking about the statistics of you making it to the NFL? That's
well, look at it. I mean, look at the story. Like, man, shit, yes, man. Everybody betting on you and they sold into you, man, to get there, man. So now you got an opportunity to change a whole lot of lives. Did his father pass away?
Yeah, I think they gave the dates on the, he passed.
Congratulations, young man.
Yes, man. Absolutely proud of that moment. And that's what you look at, man, when these life-changing moments that can happen in an instant, right?
That's what it's about.
Yeah.
That's what it's about. Long hours, long days, long nights, road trips. Gosh. Staying focused. Not paying attention to the distractions. Golly. Larry Dozier. I see you, bro. Appreciate y'all joining, man. Shit, we got like 17, 18 minutes left, man. Nothing else really matter now.
Yeah, I'm like that was very anticlimactic for us to not pick no damn body.
The game picks, so I think Belichick just feel like you need more after the first round. Maybe you see somebody with some more picks in the second round.
Okay.
What you say, y'all? How many picks y'all got? 12?
13 now.
Shit. Golly, wow.
That's a lot of picks, bro.
We didn't pick, and we got two picks behind it. So, yeah, we are up to 13.
And you know he going to make some bastard-ass picks, too, boy. Golly. Wow.
He didn't have a second-round pick, and now he got one? Shit, I think that's bad. That's a good move.
Yeah.
That's a good move. Because, I mean, what was really in the first round you think you wanted, Fees?
I want Hurts.
Oh, you want him?
Shit, he picked up two.
I just didn't think he was going to go in the first round, man.
Picked up two more draft picks.
They might
picks.
Pick him up in the second round, man.
Yeah, he not going in the first.
Yeah.
But they picked up two more draft picks in 2 days, 2 or 3 days. See if Lord know what he's doing over there.
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to wait to see what kind of product he put out there. But that ain't what I wanted.
Vikings trade the pick to the 49ers.
Uh-oh.
Oh, wow.
Come on, Shanahan. Shake this shit up, boy. Now, you know, I took a big-time wide out.
I'm about to plug this bad boy in.
Here comes it. Now, Fees, here comes your shocker pick where he takes the quarterback off the board right now.
Oh, I ain't going nowhere.
Here comes. He's gonna take a quarterback. Shanahan. They don't need a wide out. They don't need a running back. They got a plethora of running backs. Their defense is pretty solid. They got an aging defensive corner, Richard Sherman, back there. Maybe they go with that.
They pick already in, too. They knew who they wanted.
Yeah. Shit, you better you goddamn jump up that far.
Damn, I can barely hear y'all.
Yeah, I hear your TV more than anything. I
hear your damn television.
Headphones went dead.
Said TV got loud too.
Yeah. Like, fuck you doing? All them little goddamn gaming headsets you got went dead on.
You around damn it.
Around there playing Call of Duty.
Can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you. It just sounds like y'all whispering.
Oh.
You put them goddamn Call of Duty headsets back in, boy.
Selection in, 49ers. Let's see what we got.
The Kyle Shanahan got them goddamn kids over there with him.
Brandon
Ayuk.
A wide receiver out of Arizona.
You know how these cords do.
Yep.
Really?
They picked a wide receiver.
Arizona State.
God damn.
Shit, he ain't even in the mark thing. He ain't even in the mark shit. I'm trying to find his damn name.
I'm not, again, man, between him and John Lynch.
Who the hell they picked? Brandon Ayuk. Yeah. Who is that?
Oh, Arizona State.
I'm not going to knock. I can't. It's hard to say. Goddamn, Shanahan don't know what he want to see, right? Like, it's hard to goddamn say, like, you know, shit, man.
That's them this Sith dude don't Lord know what
the
moves.
Fuck he want.
That's them, huh? That's them Sith Lord moves right there.
Ah.
Fucking Dolphins.
I mean, they over there, so they watched them. They saw a lot of them.
Hey, man, and listen, they don't even have no video of this motherfucker.
I ain't never heard of him. I mean, I'm an SC fan, and I don't know who this guy is.
They're showing the video of it now.
You know they're ahead of us.
That's who the head coach over there? Herm Edwards.
Yeah,
they started out on fire this year.
You got some fucking tape. Well, you know,
they had him as a fringe first rounder, man, coming out, man.
He's like a good route runner, they for real. He got some speed on him.
Yeah, they had him predicted, man, to go to the Eagles as a fringe first rounder, man.
And a punt returner.
They guys 6'205". 65 catch, 1,100 yards this year, 18.3 receiving yards, 8 touchdowns. Ooh, oh, he ran a 4.5 at the combine, but I think his game speed is probably a little faster than that.
No, he probably actually runs a 4.5 with pads on, which says a lot.
Well, no, he said at the combine. He ran a 4.5 at the combine. But
yeah, it was like if you run a 4.5 with your pads on.
But you don't run the combine with your pads on. He ran a 4.5 at the combine.
No, I'm saying like he probably still runs a 4.5.
Oh, you said it translates over to, yeah, he's on the field. Like, yeah, he's
some guys,
much faster. Like, yeah.
You can have a guy that runs a 4.3 on a track, but he only runs a 4.5 when you put all that gear on. Not that fast. No, he runs a 4.5 and probably still runs a 4.5.
Well, I'm going to tell you like this. I'm not going to knock Shanahan.
That's a good point. All brothers been picked so far, seem like, outside of Burroughs.
I seen no Caucasian other than Tua.
Well, you know the NFL is 80% black.
Is it up to 80 now? I knew it was 70 before.
Yeah, like, I'd say 80, but shit, it's close. Like, mid to high 70s, at least.
HBCUs need to get on board, man, and check themselves.
It ain't about HBCUs, man. The system does not allow for HBCUs to compete against some of this shit.
Hey, man, they need to change that shit. That's all.
The big time athletes go to the big white schools.
Yeah, I mean, you don't have the facilities, you don't have the money, you don't have any of that stuff to do it. And
just manage your money better and make it more attractive. That's all you can do.
You say what?
Manage your money better and make it more attractive for players to want to come.
But where's the money coming from?
They have the money. They just mismanage it, man. That's most of the problem with the HBCUs. They blow it on stupid shit.
HBCUs don't have the money to build no 100,000-seat stadium.
Well, not necessarily a stadium, but you got to start from the ground up, man.
So what's the ground up? So when
your facilities, like your weight rooms, the dorms, the campus, and what you're
thinking about hundreds of millions of dollars.
Well, you got to start somewhere. That's all I'm saying. You got to start somewhere.
By the time you put in money for your dorm room, right, and you get enough money to start on the weight room, shit, by that time the dorm room's outdated. you don't have that kind of revenue coming in, man.
Y'all somebody calling in? Somebody calling.
Hey, what's going on? You on the Penn Sports? What's going on? What's your name? Where you calling from?
This Crooked King asked you. I'm in Georgia, but I'm from Florida.
He from Florida. Who your team?
Philadelphia Eagles, actually.
Okay. Are you pleased with the pick?
Huh?
Are you pleased with the pick you guys made?
I think I would have liked Jeffries, but he's a good wide receiver.
Okay.
Your phone breaking up, man. Sound like you talking to us with a cup and a string in it.
You got to turn the background noise down. That's all.
You got to turn your device down.
Hello.
Yeah, turn your other device down. Yeah.
So.
Ten minutes.
Yeah.
You still there, bro?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. You say so? You pleased with the Eagles pick, huh? Hey, Crooked King, do me a favor. Turn your TV down in your background. Yeah, you got to turn your television down. We got feedback. We're getting feedback.
Who did the Eagles pick? Did the Eagles pick the Rieger dude that
Yeah. They got Jalen Rieger.
Oh, okay. There's no way they're happy with that.
Well, he just said he is.
Did you hang up on him, G?
No, he should. We still hear his TV, so I think he's still there.
We can't hear him, so, I mean, hey, you got to turn down your television. We can't hear you.
Hello?
It don't matter.
We can't hear. Yo, you turn your TV down yet, man.
And your devices, your echo in the background. You just hang up.
My TV, hold on. All right.
On behalf of all of us at CBS Entertainment.
Okay, what you got to say for the 2020 draft so far, man? What you think?
Man, I think it's a quarterback-driven league, and they're just showing that the top three was top six picks was quarterbacks, so... It's all about money. It's quarterbacks.
Okay.
Yeah, but I mean, shit. Jordan Love and Jalen Hurts are still on the board. Neither one of them got picked.
And Jacob Eason.
Jacob Eason was never going in the first round, but the other two prospects that were projecting possibly first round are not off the board, and they're more than likely not going to get picked. Like, looking at who else has picks left in the draft. So, I mean, even though it is a quarterback-driven league, I don't think this draft was depicted by quarterbacks.
I just wanted to check in. Y'all boys, please, man. It's going to be a good season.
All right, man. Appreciate you calling in.
All right. So, this is a question I present to y'all. There has not been a single running back to come off this board.
That's crazy.
Yeah,
not one.
You're exactly right.
Not a one.
We are on pick 26, and no running backs have been picked. Green Bay ain't picking a running back. They got Aaron Jones.
Mm-mm. They have no need to.
Seattle, Baltimore, they not picking running backs.
Tennessee don't need no running back. Frisco don't need one.
That's your TV feed. We telling him to turn his TV down. That's your ass.
Hey, what?
I said we telling Cricket to turn his TV down, and that's your TV.
I don't see how. Like, my TV down so damn low.
Yeah, we can hear it, man.
Your computer got a sensitive mic on it. It's all good.
It's not the computer mic. It's the mic on this headset.
Oh, the headset, yeah.
Can't turn your goddamn TV down.
I don't have the remote. It's over there.
Matt LaFleur, what do you think you're going to do?
Yeah, just a little bit.
They ain't even sure what damn Miami got. They traded them?
Look at Nick Saban there. What do they got there interviewing Saban?
Clearly they did.
They must have traded the pick to them.
Miami traded the pick to the Packers.
The Packers on the board.
Yep. The Packers jumped up four spots.
Yep.
Okay, so what Green Bay going to do? Go ahead and do something stupid and pick Jordan Love.
I wouldn't be surprised. Like we just said, They will be the one pick I said that needed a quarterback.
They'll think that they can take Jordan Love and groom him for like 3 years behind Aaron Rodgers and try to make him something just like they tried to do with Hundley. It didn't work. We're going to see.
They picked Jordan Love.
There you go. Look at that, boy.
Jordan Love. Writing on the wall for goddamn Rodgers.
Green Bay is officially the dumbest team in the NFL.
No, we just, listen, man, when we sat, we just ran through the last 8 picks. I said the only team on this list right now that's possibly looking for a quarterback is the Green Bay Slackers if they're looking to draft that future guy. They like what Jordan Love have, but he don't have to come in and play for the next 2 years. Same thing they did with Aaron Rodgers.
Man, Aaron Rodgers was top flight when he came out of Cal. Jordan Love is not.
Well, according to disrespectful.
It's disrespectful to even compare him to what A-Rod was at Cal. Talk about Jordan Love at Utah.
What I'm telling you, there are a lot of people that are very high on Jordan Love.
And they're stupid.
This guy, man, he came in. Well, he entered high school at 5'6", at 130, 130 pounds. Now he's 6'3". And 224, 6'3" and 3/4". Okay. And
doesn't make him a quarterback.
Uh-oh. Oh, he's a quarterback. Uh-oh. He is a quarterback.
Look at that shit. Damn, he got a nice ball.
He is a quarterback.
Have you seen what he did against real, like actual competition?
Well, here's the thing, though, right? All the measurables are there. He doesn't have to come in and play right away.
Yeah, that's the measurables are there. He ain't getting nothing done.
Hey, well, you got to look at the rest of the squad that he's playing with, man.
Bam, nice throw.
Hey, man,
you know, he didn't have all the tools. He didn't have no LSU squad and shit like that.
He played against LSU this year.
That's what I'm saying. That's probably the worst footage you have of him this year. You know what I'm saying? When he played in that game.
It actually isn't. He had 0 touchdowns and 3 interceptions against LSU. He played against.
I think what he had 8 interceptions total out of his whole 4 years being at Utah. I think his screen froze up.
Who, Feeve?
Yeah.
That motherfucker's battery dead. He over there on goddamn gamer headset. Right.
He's we ain't got but 2 minutes anyway.
There you go, man. Hey, but it's been fun, man. Everybody got their picks in. Green Bay made the jump from 30 to 26. Seattle doesn't really need anybody. Baltimore is going to be kind of status quo. Tennessee has their quarterback and their running back. Green Bay just swapped with who the fuck did they swap with? I couldn't.
They swapped with was it Miami?
And then so they're gonna take that pick. San Fran, another pick in this first round, and then Kansas City. So that rounds it out, man. We appreciate everybody checking in with Petty Sports tonight. 2020 draft is basically in the books, man. No real surprises. Let us know, man. Get into our page, man. Let us know what you think about your team draft pick, and we'll see y'all next Wednesday. It's your boy DB, ATL. Rise the fuck up, and I'm out.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Like Banks just said, man, you could have been anywhere else in the world tonight, but you were right here with the crew for our first Petty Sports NFL Draft Edition, and we thank you guys, man. You could have, I mean, we had mega fun. I think the Falcons, we are pleased with the pick that we made. We'll see what we do moving forward in the rest of the draft. Some guys are disappointed, like Feeze, because they didn't make a pick, but they're added to the – but they got 13 picks now, so I'm pretty sure overall they'll come up with something to be competitive. So big shouts out to everybody that tuned in and started that watch party and kicking it with us like that tonight, man. So, yo, until next time, next Wednesday at 8 o'clock. We will see you. God willing, the creek gonna rise. We appreciate it, man. Thank Petty, man, for doing what you do out there. And check out the other shows on the platform. You got No Name the Podcast, the Petty Man Podcast. You got 808 on the Beat Friday. So check us out, man. And we appreciate your support. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And we out. ATL, I hope.
We like to thank Maceo Herb from Crush Sports for checking in today,
that's right,
man.
That's right. And all the callers that called in.
And the callers, Thomas Talmadge, Crooked King, checking in as well, man. So, man, let's go get it, man. Football season right around the corner. We'll see y'all next Wednesday. Talk about these draft picks, man. Make it happen. Run out with the plug hole, hood got the bag in. Bitch, I'm a good nigga, ho, I'm not a rapper. Run out with the plug hole, hood got the bag in. Bad bitch from the hood, she ratchet. New Glock on my hip, this plastic. I just bought a new whip, 550 M6. Got my fingers up in, I smash. Bitch, I'm a good nigga, ho, I'm